1340 96.5 KVGC, 7 minutes after the hour. Again, we would like to remind you that the funeral services for former Amador County Sheriff's Deputy Mark Lawrence are set for this morning, 11 o'clock, at the Church of the Nazarene on Ridge Road. There will be a procession for Lawrence today starting at 10:30. The route will be from Daenerys on Broadway to 88 to 49 to Sutter Hill, and then Ridge Road to the church. So expect slight delays in the affected intersections. Also, the sheriff's office will be closed. The business office will be closed from 9 to 2 today. Visitation for the jail will still be conducted. But once again, the procession will begin about 10:30 this morning, so look for slight delays along its route. And the California Department of Transportation announced yesterday that they have completed work on a project to install rumble strips in the median and outside shoulders of the roadway in Calaveras and Amador County. The installations are along Highway 4 in Calaveras County from Angels to the Calaveras-Alpine County line, Highway 26 in Calaveras County from McAlamy Hill to the Calaveras-Amador line, and Highway 26 in Amador County from the Calaveras-Amador line to Highway 88. Rumble strips are those little things on the side of the road that when your tires pass over them, they kind of rumble. You hear the noise and feel the vibration, and thus the name rumble strips. Anyway, this is part of a $4.2 million project here in Amador and Calaveras counties.
And the California Department of Forestry and Fire Protection, CAL FIRE, has announced the availability of over $80 million for forest health and fire prevention projects. CAL FIRE is soliciting applications for projects that work to proactively prevent catastrophic wildfires and restore forests to healthy, functioning ecosystems, while also sequestering carbon and reducing greenhouse gas emissions. An additional $7 million will be available through the Forest Legacy Program to conserve environmentally important forest land threatened with conversion to non-forest uses, and up to $2 million will be available specifically for applied research examining forest management and health. The grant program will fund local projects that address the risk of wildfire and reduce wildfire potential to communities in and adjacent to forested areas. Find more information and sign up for announcements online at fire.ca.gov/grants.
And the California legislature recently approved new regulations to give the state more oversight over medical exemptions for school vaccinations. Senate Bill 276, signed by Governor Newsom, creates a standard medical exemption request form overseen by the state's public health officer and also allows the health department to review exemptions at schools where less than 95% of the students are vaccinated. Schools that fail to report their rates or from doctors writing more than 5 exemptions in a given year also. Protests were held at the state capitol in response to this new legislation. The Secretary of State's office now reports that a ballot measure has been submitted to repeal the new rules. If it makes it to the statewide ballot, it would require a majority vote.
And the Amador County branch of Umpqua Bank recently made a generous donation of $4,000 to the Amador Tuolumne Community Action Agency for children homeless support. The donation will be used for the Homeless Student Fund for the Tuolumne Shelter. It'll buy Chromebooks for children at the shelter to check out and use for school-related projects while at the shelter, as well as provide school supplies on an as-needed basis. There continues to be an alarming increase in the number of children entering emergency homeless shelters in Amador and Tuolumne. In 2017, 59 children who stayed at the Tuolumne and Amador County shelter. In fiscal year 18, 80 children needed emergency shelter service. And in the first quarter of this year, ACCA had already assisted 24 children. They anticipate more than 100 by year's end.
And come one, come all to the annual Bark in the Park tomorrow from 8:30 to 1. Dieter Park in Jackson. There'll be a mutt strut, dog games, canine sheriff's demonstration, speed zone, vendors, food, and more. Bring your dog. Join the fun. The event, $25 tomorrow. $10 in advance. Seniors and military members, only $18 to enter your dogs. All proceeds benefit the APAL adoption, spay, and neuter programs on Scooby's 50th birthday.
And give blood, save lives at the Veteran Community Blood Drive, Monday, September 30th, 10:30 to 5:30 at the American Legion Hall on Sutter Hill. And as a thank you gift, donors will go home with a Vitalant t-shirt. Make sure to bring photo ID, always eat and drink plenty of water before donating. For more info, contact 304-8770 or vitalant.org.
And breathe deep, Amador, at the Crazy Hat and Hair 5K Walk and Fun Run tomorrow with Longevity. The Breathe Deep Amador Walk and Run begins at the Italian Picnic Grounds at 9 o'clock with the check-in. The fun takes off at 9:45. A brunch starts at 10:30. Join in the fun and help change the outcome for people with lung cancer. For more information, you can give Allison a call at 312-407-6103. And that's a quick look at local news on a Gold Country Friday morning from the KVGC News Center.
I'm JD.
And I'm Jim Geedy reporting. Remember, for the latest news, traffic, and weather 24 hours a day, you can always visit our website at kvgcradio.com.